All right. Well, good morning. I'm John Thewitt. I'm with the Azure Specialized Compute Group. I'm a industry program manager focused on media and entertainment, and we're going to talk about rendering in Azure today. Sort of the flow is a little introduction to rendering, why render in the cloud, and then the value of rendering in Azure. So what is rendering? Definition is generating an image from a 2D, or more often commonly a 3D image, from a 3D model. I mean, so you're taking a 3D model and creating an image. The data input structure consists of geometry, viewpoint, shading, lighting, texturing. Basically, it brings models to life. Rendering is by far the most compute-intensive component if you're looking at an entire production lifecycle from storyboard to final production. If you counted all the computational core hours, rendering would probably be about 90% of that consumption. It is a highly complex distributed process with dependencies between the render nodes and the digital assets, the storage. So there's different types of rendering. At the highest level, there's real-time and offline rendering. As it sounds like, real-time is for gaming and interactive processes where you're measuring response time in milliseconds or tens of milliseconds. Offline rendering is, you might think of stuff like theatrical visual effects, where it can take over 24 hours to render a single frame. Sometimes, you know, double, triple that. Then there's different types of rendering, depending on the look and feel and the attributes you want out of the render. Rasterization for speed. You're computing more on primitives or elements, which are usually triangles, which is rather than pixel by pixel, which is a much faster process. Ray casting and ray tracing. You have a specific viewpoint, different levels of optical sophistication in how reflection is handled. Radiosity is calculated independent of camera. It's more surface oriented. And you get a real, it's accounts for indirect illumination very well. And oftentimes these are used in combination with one another. Again, depending on the look and feel you're looking for. Now, who uses rendering? And I like to throw this slide up there because a lot of people just think of rendering and gaming and visual effects. It's usually you really use across multiple industries. You know, advertising and marketing for prototyping, packaging. Think architecture, urban planning for 3D modeling. You know, walkthroughs, fly-through, drive-throughs. Spatial planning, you know, parks, all that. Oil industry, reservoir analysis, manufacturing, automotive, aerospace, you know, like modeling, concept cars, wingspan, seats, part placement, all that sort of stuff. So this is a very, very simplified typical production pipeline from pre-production, production, post-production. Just showing you where rendering fits within there between, you know, concept, storyboard, modeling, rigging, animation, to final production. And you have asset management tools across the span of those. And then just showing some of the specific software like 3ds Max and Autodesk Maya, RenderMan, Arnold V-Ray, some of the popular rendering machines that we support. This is a VFX pipeline, so a little more detailed view. VFX, visual effects. This is also simplified because this is showing a sort of a left to right flow. In reality, there's multiple iterations back that would be, so to be arrows going all the way back to different boxes and recirculating several iterations. So again, you'll hear about the rendering pipeline. It's a very complex distributed environment. So why would somebody want to render in the cloud? It's really similar reasons you want to render for almost any application, but for rendering it's even more pronounced, because if you've worked in a production pipeline, generally the rendering needs are most heavy at the end of the pipeline. So if you have 10,000 cores on premise, you might need 30,000 in the last 2 months of production. So it lends itself very well to bursting environment. So again, why would you want to render in the cloud? Just to scale, you know, tens of thousands of cores available as needed at different times in the cycle. And the elasticity to scale up and down in that environment as needed. Only paying for what you use. The reach and locality, you have artists, workers wherever they are with Azure with over 42 data centers around the globe, there's always a data center fairly close to that artist, if latency is a concern. Hardware selection, you always have the latest and greatest hardware available. You're not worried about 3-year capital depreciation life cycles. No infrastructure cost or less infrastructure cost if you're bursting to the cloud. Obviously you're not paying for the space, the heating, the cooling, the power, et cetera. And there are known controlled costs. You know what it's going to cost per compute hour, per storage going in. Just a rendered image of a vessel from a company we work with, Oceaneering. Again, just sort of showing, I know I'm at a gaming show, but just showing the diversity of the rendering in a different application. And this company does a lot of sort of aquatics, submersibles, vessels, windmills. So what does Azure offer? I like to think of it as a compute platform. Obviously at the lowest level, you've got your hardware, the infrastructure, and what we'll call the cloud services on top of that, the IS, the infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, the virtualization, the operating system, middleware, runtime stuff. At the top level, you have your application and developers running whatever it is you're running, whatever application you're working. You still need to connect the infrastructure with your application, just like you would on premise. You need to build out, manage, and configure that environment. Azure has several tools to help orchestrate, provision, manage that environment. One's called Azure Batch, one's called Cycle Cloud, and we'll talk about those a little more and how they help simplify and let you get access to that massive compute power. All right, somebody would yell at me if I didn't put up at least what our platforms look like. So, you know, everything from entry level to high level, high performance, optimized for different environments. The great thing is somebody asked me what's the best VM virtual machine for them. It's like, I don't know, let's find out. It's really easy to benchmark to figure out the exact VM that is optimal for your environment. Also like to plan out, if you have a big cluster on premise, by definition, it cannot be optimized for all of your workflows. In the cloud, I mean, if you have 1,000 core cluster running for 10 hours, or 10,000 core cluster running for 1 hour, or 10 1K clusters running for 1 hour each, it all costs the same. So what's your environment? What makes the most sense for you to implement? So, how to render in Azure. There's a couple different ways, and we can work with managed render services via partners. Azure has software and services. I mentioned Azure Batch is sort of a plumbing, we'll just call it at a high level. Azure Batch Rendering is Azure Batch plus pay-per-use licensing and templates. And Cycle Cloud is a complete end-to-end workflow orchestration tool. Also, of course, you need storage to match, and whether it's object, NFS, distributed storage. Recently, we acquired Avere, which has a huge footprint in media and entertainment, which is a real good hybrid storage solution. A little bit on managed services. All the partners are a little bit different in what they offer and what they do. I'm just trying to give a little overview of a sort of generalized what they do, but it's they simplify the complexity of managing and controlling the render pipeline. Several of them have hybrid solutions. You can mix on-premise with cloud. Support for most of the favorite software out there. I don't want to say all of it, because then somebody would ding me. And a few of those partners we work with are Conductor, Cube from Pipeline FX, Royal Render, RenderWise. There's a few others. Got to throw up an image once in a while. This is from a something called Anchors Up, was rendered using Cube as a managed service on a managed service on Azure. And that was an animated feature. So at Azure Batch, this is back to the sort of the platform picture we saw earlier. We've got your lower layer hardware and cloud services at the lowest level, and then your application on top. There's a bunch of configuration, management, provisioning, queuing tasks. How do you manage hardware failures? How do you manage software failures? Authentication. Azure Batch takes care of that for you, simplifies that plumbing for you. So avoid building infrastructure. You have people work on making your application more efficient. It's being used in media transcoding, rendering, and other industries. Financial services, we have a pretty good footprint. Some manufacturing. Batch rendering. So again, that is more of a single license, single point of entry to simplify. So we're finding interest in this more in smaller and medium-sized shops that may not have site-wide licensings with the larger software providers. So for a single license, you can pay for your software, your Arnold, V-Ray, Maya tools, as well as the consumption and storage that go along with that, and have a single point of payment. Microsoft, I guess, in its commitment to M&E, has made some recent acquisitions. One of them being CycleCloud. So CycleCloud's a complete end-to-end workflow orchestration tool. It's very valuable in an IT organization that wants to manage multiple projects, multiple departments, multiple project being a game or a visual effects effort, whatever it might be. It helps you separate cost controls, set thresholds on number of cores that are available to certain people, send alerts to management, that sort of tool. Sort of a pictorial representation of CycleCloud, what they do, and the idea being it's a complete life cycle from start to finish. It's not just simplifying your initial onboarding and such, it's ongoing. Optimization and management of that environment. Also recent acquisition of Avere I mentioned. Avere is in pretty much every major studio and VFX shop around. Helps you eliminate latency between on-premise and cloud. Helps you reduce the amount of data you need to move between cloud and on-premise, which reduces your egress cost, of course. Helps you keep your storage as an NFS environment and still transfer that to blob or inexpensive object storage in the cloud without having to go through hoops to make that happen, which you do with some other solutions. So this is a simple solution or workflow showing a rendered management station and rendering and storage on premise with the Avere FXT, sort of a replication of that in the cloud, being synced by the software and managed with the authentication and another login and analytic tools you get with Azure. Slightly different, some of our partners, this is Cube, they don't put a managed node in the cloud, they manage it all from on premise. So there's just, I put that in as an example, there's just different ways to go about it. We would sit down and go through what's your requirements, what do you prefer. I'm not going to go through all this, but these are an actual requirement list from somebody we're working on it with a rendering in the cloud project. And suffice to say, we have the VMs, the storage, the security, temporary storage to meet the needs. I mean, there's a variety of services, all are not listed here. I do want to point on the security side, we have by far the most certifications and of any cloud vendor. We're the only CSP that's MPAA independently audited, certified, with CDSA certified, and a bunch of other European ones that I can't remember all the acronyms for. A bunch of partners, a few we've mentioned already, Avid and Adobe, two big ones I haven't mentioned, and several others. I mean, the V-Ray integration with The Azure batch rendering was just announced a couple weeks ago. I want to leave it with a quote from Jellyfish. They're a VFX shop that we work with out of the UK, pretty good size. But I think this comment from Jeremy Smith, their CTO, encompasses a lot of the benefits of Azure. So the beauty of Azure GPUs is we get the top-end GPU at our disposal, so the latest and greatest hardware at their fingertips. Paid for by the minute, hour, or week, so only paying for what they use. If I hire 10 contractors a month, I'd have to buy dedicated workstations savings. So the ability to elastically expand when need be, not explicitly stated there, those 10 workers can be anywhere in the world. By using HPC, we have a lot more confidence going after big jobs. So just knowing they have access to tens of thousands of cores, they can go after jobs they couldn't go after a year ago, or more jobs, you know, simultaneously. That's a Jellyfish render, and that's all I had. Any questions? We're good? All right, thank you for spending your morning.